you'll know, today is International Women's Day, a fantastic opportunity for us to just take some time to reflect on and celebrate the women within our communities and across the globe, actually. We're delighted to have so many remarkable young girls and women within our community here at St. Michael's Prep. And the following video just gives you a bit of an insight into some of their stories, some of their achievements, and some of the successes that we are celebrating today. So please take a few minutes just to enjoy the following video.
My greatest achievement is that I can read in English and Dutch, and I can speak two languages.
My greatest achievement was completing the New York Virtual Marathon in 2020. A virtual race is tough when you're on your own without the crowd cheering you on. But on this particular day, the weather was also against me. I had 40 mile an hour headwinds, rain, hail. Everything was against me, but I didn't give up. And completing that race is my greatest achievement because it's made me feel that I can face the toughest of physical challenges and do it. So it was a tough day. I cried, I battled, and I made it over the finish line. And it's a race and an achievement I'll never forget.
My greatest achievement is writing a book with my grandmother called The Stories My Grandmother Told Me More. The process was a bit difficult, but I had lots of people to help me and I got really great reviews.
My greatest achievement is saying a poem in my school in front of more than 500 people.
My greatest achievement is when I won the Billings Cup for Girls' Board. It made me feel happy and excited.
Our greatest achievements are doing well in sports
and came joint first in cross country.
My greatest achievement, playing the saxophone. I took it up in my 20s, I did some early grades in my 30s when my children were small, and then in my 40s I thought, oh, I'd like to go a bit higher. I had to do my grade 5 theory, I worked really hard, I got a distinction. I then did my grade 6 saxophone. It was a terrible exam, I had a sore throat, I thought I'd failed, and I scraped a pass. And I felt the same sense of achievement for both of them.
My greatest achievement is when I went to Bedway with Evie and completed the red one.
My greatest achievement is my head teacher's award for lovely expression when reading. I love reading. And my favourite book is The Mouse's Wedding.
My greatest achievement is football. It's a sport I've always been passionate for. Football has no gender, and it makes me so happy that we now live in a world where gender equality doesn't matter and that there are so many successful women footballers. Happy International Women's Day, in a world where gender equality is so powerful. Let's carry on making a difference.
My greatest achievement is getting a distinction in Lambda.
One of my greatest achievements is teaching myself to paint. I started in the first lockdown. I have practiced every single day, and I mean every single day. But it just goes to show what practice can do, because I'm actually not too bad now, and I was dreadful before. Here is a little wren that I painted earlier. I've got my own postcards, a couple of them there. I've got my own cards that I send to my friends. There it goes. And I've even had a famous poet who has written a poem about one of my pictures. So just go for it. Don't let anything stop you. Practice, try, and you'll be amazed what you can achieve.
My greatest achievement is when I became a vegetarian, and I've been one now for 4 years, and I don't want to hurt the animals and I want to save the planet.
My greatest achievement is I climbed one of the highest mountains in Lake District when I was only 2, and also I did a marathon in the Christmas holidays, more than a marathon.
My greatest achievement that I've taught wild kittens how to walk.
My greatest achievement is staying positive whatever the situation and always trying to learn and adapt. Adapt to new countries, learn new languages and new cultures. I've lived in France, in Germany, in Switzerland and now in England. Adapting to new jobs, you know, learning new skills. I've been a translator, a data manager, a marketing specialist and a language teacher. You can't always choose what happens to you, but you can choose how you respond to them. Stay positive, be resilient, and keep smiling.
International Women's Day is celebrated on the 8th of March.
Purple is the colour of International Women's Day. Every female in the world is getting mimosa. This is mimosa. Last year was a very hard year for me, but I've achieved a lot. I learned how to draw, I learned how to play chess, and I read all these books. Congratulations to all girls and females.
My greatest achievement is, apart from having two sons who I absolutely adore and who are now grown up and wonderful, is becoming head here. I never expected to be head of St Michael's. It wasn't on my radar. I loved being a teacher and thought I would always stay being a teacher. So to become head and to absolutely love it is just been a wonderful achievement for me. And the other thing you may not know is that I also helped to run a contact centre for children who don't get to see both their parents. If their parents have split up and one parent lives in a different house from another, then the children can come and see me at a special centre that we have on a Saturday afternoon. And we have lots and lots of fun at that centre. And I feel that that's a real achievement because it keeps families together and it keeps the children seeing both mummy and daddy and having a lovely time. So that for me is a really proud achievement. And we have to do lots of fundraising for it as well, which I also really enjoy.
My biggest achievement is learning how to roller skate.
I'm really proud of my achievement for doing the genie play and finishing in year three, which is my command.
My greatest achievement would be being a surrogate for my best friend. Her and her husband tried to get pregnant for 11 years. And after I'd had my three children, I offered to be a surrogate for her 5 years ago. And Nathaniel is now in reception.
One of my biggest achievements was passing the 11 plus.
My greatest achievement is that I successfully auditioned for a huge dance school in London to train professionally when I was 18. And to get in, I had to go through loads of auditions. I had to dance, I had to sing, I had to act. And it was really, really tough. And I worked so, so hard to prepare for my audition. So I was really, really proud of myself when I got in and completed my degree there.
My greatest achievement is getting brown belt in karate, which is only one away from black.
My greatest achievement is graduating from university. As well as receiving a first class degree in my subject, I also had my work published in numerous newspapers, won 7 different awards for my writing, and I even learnt to drive while I was at university. A month after I graduated, I was also very lucky to start working with the team at St Michael's. I'm very proud of what I achieved in that short space of time.
My greatest achievement was leading the first violins of the National Children's Orchestra of my age group.
One of my biggest achievements was walking a nighttime marathon around London with some friends, and we raised a lot of money for cancer research, so we were really proud.
My greatest achievement is that I made lovely friends.
Here are some of my achievements. Firstly, working for the BBC in the plays department and drama series department as an assistant floor manager and then a location manager for 10 years. Secondly, working in a deprived area with secondary school children, being their mentor and also having a tutor group, helping them to form their lives and make a success of their lives. And then after that, I got my dream job at St Michael's, working along lovely colleagues, children and parents. And the last thing is beating breast cancer, and that was with the help of my medical team, friends, families and colleagues.
My biggest achievement is winning lots of competitions with my pony Dilly. And because we've never done dressage before, we had to learn it together, even though he's a bit cheeky.
My greatest achievement is happiness.
through all the ups and downs, trying to keep happy as much as I can. Keep smiling, everyone.
In the celebration of International Women's Day, which is taking place on Monday, the 8th of March, I am torn between two events in my time at St Michael's. For my first one was like winning the All-Rounder Achievement Cup in Year 6, which was a wonderful honour, but I think being made Deputy Head Girl this year, which is my last year at St Michael's, has to be the greatest achievement to date.
When thinking about my greatest achievements, my mind immediately thought of my children or my musical career, but then I realised that actually I've shown great resilience in coping with my family life and balancing it with my work. And I think that has to be one of my greatest achievements.
My biggest achievement is that when we've moved around, that I've adapted to lots of different cultures.